next guest spent 6 seasons as a sword-wielding, shield-maiden Viking on Vikings, which is very aggressive for a Canadian. Now she's a PI in Big Sky. Watch it Tuesdays at 10 here on ABC. Please welcome Catherine Winnick. Hi, Catherine.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Hey, I know you're a Canadian. I know you're up in Vancouver right now. Congratulations on being named number one best country in the world. That's got to be exciting.
It's pretty amazing here in Vancouver. It really is.
Your parents, I understand, are Ukrainian.
Yes. I'm actually first generation Canadian, but both my parents were born over there, and they brought me over here I was born in Canada, and I had to speak Ukrainian, my first language.
Really? You're a Ukrainian, I guess, huh? Yeah.
Pretty traditional family, yes.
Were they? They raised you with the old country ways?
Yeah, pretty strict. We spoke Ukrainian at home, obviously English as well. We went to Ukrainian school every Saturday, which is always a pain in the butt when you're...
Oh, you
have to go every Saturday, but...
What do they teach you at Ukrainian school? Is that you learned the language, or is
it more than that? We learn about the traditions, about the Ukrainian culture, and how to make pierogies.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, that's important. That's probably number one on the most important Ukrainian traditions list, right?
Babushki pierogies. You gotta make that.
You are a martial artist as well. You even owned your own martial arts studio. What kind of martial arts did you study, or do you study?
I actually became obsessed with Taekwondo. I started 7 years old, got my first black belt at the age of 13, and started my martial arts school at the age of 16 called Wing Chun Martial Arts.
At 16 years old, you were teaching other people to do martial arts.
Yeah, do martial arts.
Like adults?
We had adults, we had kids, family. I was actually pretty strict too. They would come in, they would have to bow down to me at a certain angle. And if they ever, you know, misspoke, they had to do push-ups. They would actually sit on their backs, and they had to do push-ups with me on their backs just to really kind of put them
in place. My kids subject me to that same punishment. So what did you say the name of the place was?
Wing Chun Martial Arts.
Wing Chun, does that mean something?
Well, it's actually from my last name. Winnick is the first part of Win, and Kai in Korean means the art of the foot.
The art of the foot. Oh, so Cobra Kai is like the snake foot.
I guess so, yes. You
can I guess so. Wow, we really learn some things sometimes, right, Guillermo?
Right, Jimmy, yeah.
This is, by the way, I assume this was like your big break. You played Donald Trump's first wife, Ivana, in a television movie in, what, 2005?
It was my very first kind of lead on a TV show. It was an ABC TV movie called Trump Unauthorized. And I remember getting in, I was so nervous and so excited that I decided just to try to get, you know, really into the character, really get into the role. And I looked her up, I know she's Czech, and I started working with the accent. And I decided to go a full method. I had everybody on set call me Katarina Anna Vinitska, because I just thought that's what you do as an actor. You show up kind of in character.
Yes.
And came in with like literally a mink coat that I had to borrow from my grandmother, her only mink coat, wore pumps and high heels every day to set, my hair done up. And it was just one of those things. I'm like, oh my gosh, I took myself way too seriously. And it wasn't until literally about a year later ago, I was in Aspen skiing and I'm at the Little Nell Hotel and I hear this voice. What do you mean I lost my reservations? I'm like, wait a second. I know that voice. I know that. I recognize that voice from anywhere. And I turn around and I see the back of this woman, the statuesque woman, wearing this long mink coat with high heels and her hair done up. And I'm like, no way. No way. This can't be. This can't be. And I walk up to her. I'm like, Ivana Trump? And she looks at me and she's like, yes. I'm like, what? Well, I'm Ivana Trump. I mean, no, I played you in a movie, and I was just so awestruck. She was kind of like my first celebrity that I met back in the day. This was way before Trump became president, by the way.
Yeah, yeah, sure, yeah.
And I asked her, I'm like, have you seen the movie? And she's like, nope, I have not seen yet. And so it was one of those things. I'm like, wow, it was just...
I bet Donald watched it. I bet you he watched it a lot of times.
I don't know. He might have, actually. He actually might have.
Wow. That's pretty crazy to run. So she wasn't thrilled to see you, it sounds like.
I don't know. I don't really think so, but I hope she liked the movie. It was one of my first big breaks before Vikings, and
For Vikings. By the way, I have noticed that your fans from Vikings are just absolutely buzzing about the fact that you're. Oh, and there's quite a few of them here as well.
I'm pretty lucky.
Have they followed you to Big Sky? Do you feel that they've appropriately moved?
I have such diehard fans. It's pretty absolutely amazing.
Yeah, because you could beat them up if they don't, you know?
Oh, hell yeah. And just also seeing them, like, even on Comic-Con, and one of the weirdest things is when you see them in person and they lift up their sleeves and there's tattoos of my face on their bodies. And it's pretty gnarly when you actually see them and you're like, wait a second, don't take yourself so seriously as a TV show, but.
Don't you ever feel like the fair thing to do would be to tattoo one of them on your bodies? Your body?
That's where, yeah. Yeah. It's pretty amazing. We have crazy fans.
You know, John Stamos was on a moment ago. He's got a show called Big Shot by David E. Kelly.
And Big Sky, David E. Kelly.
Yeah, yeah. I hope he doesn't get confused and make you start playing basketball in the middle of it.
Hey, I could teach him some karate and it will work.
Ooh, that would be a good crossover event. You beat the living crap out of John Stamos while he's coaching basketball.
Come on, John, let's go. I'll
something to think about. I think it's something Ivana Trump would appreciate. Well, it's very good to have you on the show. The show is called Big Sky. It airs Tuesday nights, 10 o'clock here on ABC. Catherine Winnick, everybody. Thank you, Catherine.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with music from Easy Life. Congratulations on making it to the end of a YouTube video. Why not celebrate by clicking the subscribe button? You earned it.